continue with Backstage Pass here on Urban TV. It's time to give you a little bit of the past, a little bit of the future, with a very fantastic mix brought to you by Bell Jams, and they're presenting the All-Star Tour by Swangs Avenue. When you mention Swangs Avenue, these are the originators of urban music, I'd say, here in Uganda. Now, they're going to be going right across the country with an all-star lineup of artists that will be performing north, east, west, south, and finally settling right here in Kampala for a massive finale. Now, where does one even start with Swangs Avenue? What are your memories of Swangs Avenue?
Well, Swangs Avenue has been, I mean, these guys have brought up artists and they've, you know, produced some good music over time. I mean, 10 years.
10 long years.
They've really given us good music. I mean, before we knew, okay, Benon and Van People, when they came on the stage, they were singers at all, giving us some good tracks that were hit on radio. And then Benon goes back doors and starts, you know, producing music.
Yeah.
Joins Swangs Avenue. It was around 2008. And that's when, you know, guys like, you know, Mozilla Radio and Weezer were coming up.
True.
Vampino somehow was going solo.
Clear Cut.
There was Clear Cut. So they had been around, but I mean, right now, you know, they're trying to stop their mark. And then we were having Michael Ross at the time.
Doing that kind of
music as well. And, but, you know, credit to them. These guys have been, you know, some of the guys you will say, the protagonists at pushing urban music onto the musical scene. I mean, they deserve all the credits. I mean, we've seen so many artists who've come in. Irene Charil, Winnie Nwaje, all these guys have gone through their hands. Michael Owuma also doing some work there.
Yeah.
All these guys have gone through their hands. And they do some incredible stuff in Muyenga there. So right now, you know, celebrating 10 years, they decided to go on a countrywide tour. Countrywide tour, I mean, exposing, of course, some of these artists onto the other regions.
Yeah.
And then, of course, bringing these artists who recently put us on the floor to listen to their Who Is Who challenge to try probably and take that battle as well countrywide, probably. Is that what you'll be seeing? Because we saw it on the night.
Yeah, I know.
We saw it on the night and someone silenced all the other rappers. But before we get to go there, let's see what.
When was the first time you heard about Swangs? What are your favorite memories, artists from Swangs Avenue?
I was still in school when Swangs was formed, but you know, I used to vibe with music from a long time. I started vibing with them when they brought Sarah, the late.
Ah, yes. She was part of Swangs, huh?
Yeah, she was part of Swangs.
Yeah.
She had some very nice music. Then they brought Irene Tari.
Short-lived, yeah.
They have Joe Kisache. They've had Winnie Nwaje, and now the latest, Vinka, who has like her hits are played everywhere right now. So I believe Swangs as a whole is doing a very good job at what they are very good at what they do.
Yeah.
Because there's no artist they put their hands on and the artist doesn't blow. So yeah, I believe celebrating their 10 years in style was a good idea, throwing a concert. Because they're first doing tours, then they throw a concert on the 31st, I think, of August at Lugogo Cricket Oval. It's going to be great.
We cannot talk about Swangs and not talk about the fact that some big artists, even the smaller ones, have jumped ship very recently. They all kind of left together. It was like, we're done with Swangs Avenue. So, are these the last kicks of a dying horse? Is there a horse trying to come back to life? Is it still running in the right direction? Is it galloping or... What's going on here? What do you think is going on with Swang, though?
I believe like any other journey, you always find humps and hurdles, you know. But to me, I believe most artists living, they feel like it's their time to grow, you know, like be their own person. You know, having a record label behind you, there's a way it kind of like governs your life.
Of course.
Get. And it governs your income. And most people, the
as
artists
well,
in
yeah.
Uganda...
Yeah.
Their music is their business, you get. So I think they would like to control that side of the money themselves.
For Swangs, they have to stay innovative and to keep, you know, writing that music industry, because they can't keep artists. They shouldn't expect to keep that artist under their wings forever. Something will always come up and they will leave the label.
I mean, that's not even too different from a normal family. At one point, we all have to leave home,
exactly.
Even though we love them. But yeah, who are you looking forward to seeing on the circuit? Any artists in particular you want to see perform
on a tour?
Yeah.
Well, I'm more interested in these the three chaps who brought out the Who's Who challenge. I'm really more in. Yeah. The agent and Jim Nola also did, but I mean, Fefe Busi silenced them with a freestyle, and everyone gave them a deafening applause, which was so cool. So me, I'm more interested in it because first of all, they are upcoming. Yes, we'll be having all these others, Sheba, all these others also on the tour. But I mean, I'm more interested to see how everyone is reacting to that because I mean, everyone is saying this is a hip hop year. So we don't know whether this is a hip hop year.
We'll see how that works out. Michael, who are you planning, or rather, who are you looking forward to seeing at throughout the tour?
Fefe Busi, one, Fix for Maker. I'm a fan.
Okay.
Vinka.
You're now a groupie,
I've not
man.
I've not seen her like perform.
Yeah.
Vinka, so I'm looking forward for her also. Yeah, and I believe it's also a good step for her, you know, attending the big concert. And as you're seeing, they're kind of giving platform to the younger guys now, like, I mean, which is a good thing, I believe, also.
We'll see about that as Bell Jams takes 10 years off Swangs Avenue, literally across the country. There will be a finale right here in Kampala. And as always here on Backstage Pass, we will be taking you along the journey right through the country and finally here in the central region. When we return in a short while here on the show, we've got something special for you. Each and every session of Backstage Pass, we'll take you back in time and take a look at one of our favorite concerts from way back. We have a surprise coming up. The entertainment industry is about to get a major boost in terms of the whole country. Entertainment literally going countrywide. But before I tell you about a special announcement, I'd like to say happy birthday, not to Benon, but to his baby. Happy birthday to Swangs, man. How you doing, man?
I'm good. I'm feeling good and happy.
10 years ago, did you see yourself being interviewed by Denzel?
No. I'd be a liar. Hey, Mr. DJ, go select a wake, need a baby wake,
joined in 2009. I left I think after 4 years, but we're still here, we're still together, we've been together all the way.
A lot of businesses hardly survive after 3-4 years, and we're really humbled and honored and grateful to still be existing and doing some business here and there. Na, na, na. Na,
I'm looking forward to the tour going on around. Are you going to be going on around the country as well?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. Until the end, I'm with them. I'm going to be with them the entire way.
To celebrate our 10-year anniversary, we are taking the party in different towns. Masaka, Gulu, Arua, and Mbale.
What does it take for you to say, I can work with this person, I can't work with this person?
What does it take for me to decide who to work with? I mean, it's music. So first of all, the music has to be good. You know what I mean? So I must be interested in music, or I should believe your music has potential to cross borders and, you know, be good to people's ears.
We need watch. Boy, boy. Slim Prince again.
Watch me bounce to the team. Why did you associate with this venture?
Well, you know, today we launched the reason why we're actually doing this, and there was a clip that just took us through the memory lane of Swans Avenue.
We know there's so many songs you've penned, so many songs you're behind. Are there some favorites that over the years have just stood out for you? Is there anything like that?
I'm here to create my favorite. I'm here to create it. That's why I want to do an album, an old album. I mean, they're doing a tour. I believe it's only right there's an album behind the tour.
So for us, when they were celebrating 10 years, it was a match made in heaven. We were like, you know what? Let's actually celebrate with them. And through that, first of all, celebrate the music, all the musicians for their hard work, but also recognize them.
Ugandan music on a personal level. From Swangs Avenue, who are the ones who have always stood out for you over the years?
Benon and Vampos, from the time when they used to perform at like DV8. Started up when you say that you love I. And I really know what I think I. And make sure that I kick up all the rich guys who want to come and take you out of me eyes. Vampos, even when he still does music alone, he comes with something so unique. You've seen his jumps, his dancehall. He's so unique, and he's Ugandan, he doesn't force anything. I feel like Vampos is one of the best that they have, but I can't miss out Irene Tale. Irene Tale is such a sensation, man. Everywhere I watch her, and even herself, I used to see her perform at, she had a band, and then she came to Swangs. They took her to another level. For me, those two stand out any day. Baby the Baba moving to the sound. A big Nash genius
from the town. The anthem. Before you take over. All the time.
Really? How different?
All the time. Last time in studio, you had your hair looking purple or green?
Yeah, green.
You don't even know. She's just like, yeah. Always looking all the time. Always looking different all the time. We have Vinka right here, and you will be going across the country as well, right?
Yeah, right.
Looking forward to a very long journey. Is there one particular part of Uganda you can't wait to go and turn up at? Maybe you haven't been there before.
Arua, maybe. I'm excited about Arua. Basically, northern Uganda.
What are your expectations? You think they'll know all the songs?
Yeah, I think so too. I was in Jinja last weekend and it was lit, so I think Arua will be amazing.
Just get behind the song. What was the inspiration behind the song?
Well, the song is not about eating chips and ketchup, yeah? The song is about love. You know you can't eat chips without ketchup. So I'm telling this guy, our love is like chips and ketchup, you know? Yeah, that's what the song is about. Love. Oh, nyana bulunji, olibe inene, onosula kotene, onaleta yetene, tunaya kachiene, nguchadeke wangene.
We've cleared the air. We've cleared the air right here. Before we say goodbye, I'm looking forward to working with other musicians on the circuit. What can we expect? Anything special we can expect from you on the tour?
Well, I'm gonna be on the tour first of all. I'm gonna do songs with different artists in Uganda. I'll be excited about that. Yeah.
international noti loko nyagalango mwana muto tuzanyenga akina popo I don't think the way we go tuzanye kupe popo popo eh give me ketchup mabezi na kochisi na ketchup